I'm Sergeant Daniel Medrano of the Henderson Police Department's Public Information Office. This critical incident community briefing is intended to provide you with information about an officer-involved shooting that occurred in the city of Henderson on April 13, 2024. This is the first officer-involved shooting involving a city of Henderson police officer in 2024. The city of Henderson Police Department is committed to valuing and preserving human life. The protection and preservation of all human life, including the lives of individuals taken into custody, is the department's fundamental objective and primary duty of all Henderson Police Department employees. You are about to hear pertinent communications, see relevant video footage, learn about evidence and our response related to this incident to provide you with a better understanding of what occurred based on what is known to this point in the investigation. This incident briefing is in no way intended to draw any conclusions about whether the officers involved acted consistent with our policies and the law until all the facts are known and the investigation is complete. A word of caution, the images you are about to see may be disturbing and you may hear strong language. When a police officer uses force to arrest a subject or defend against an attack, it can be graphic and difficult to watch. Viewer discretion is strongly advised.
Hello. I'm Jonathan Boucher, Deputy Chief of Support for the Henderson Police Department. The following is a brief overview of a barricaded criminal incident that resulted in an officer-involved shooting that began on April 12, 2024, at approximately 11 a.m. at 295 Callan Falls Avenue. The suspect in this barricade was wanted pursuant to an incident which had occurred on March 5, 2024, at approximately 12:23 p.m., when a Henderson police officer conducting a traffic stop was approached by a concerned citizen. The citizen advised he had a male in the back of his vehicle who claimed to be the victim of a kidnapping. While interviewing the victim, officers learned that the suspects were currently located at a Henderson address on Pickled Pepper Place. When officers arrived at the address, they made contact with one of the suspects who was taken into custody. The second suspect, identified as 31-year-old Trevor Cooper, fled from the scene. Officers attempted to locate Trevor, but he escaped the area at that time. After conducting a thorough investigation, detectives developed probable cause to arrest the suspect in custody and Trevor for the following charges: one count, first-degree kidnapping; one count, battery resulting in substantial bodily harm; one count of administer drug to aid in a felony crime; and one count of conspiracy to commit kidnapping. On April 12, 2024, at about 11 a.m., officers from the Criminal Apprehension Team, or CATS team, located Trevor at the residence of 295 Callan Falls Avenue. Officers from the CATS team made contact with a roommate who advised that Trevor was armed with a high-powered rifle with access to over 1,000 rounds of ammunition, was wearing body armor, and multiple other weapons were inside the residence. Officers were also told Trevor stated he was willing to shoot it out with the cops and would commit suicide by cop. Since Trevor was barricaded inside the residence with several firearms, was wanted for violent felony offenses, and posed a continuing threat to both citizens and officers, the Henderson Police Department SWAT and crisis negotiation teams were called to assist with taking Trevor into custody. Our SWAT and crisis negotiation teams are highly trained in all aspects of barricade situations. Their primary mission is to resolve these types of incidents with an emphasis on the protection of life for all parties involved. They accomplish this by utilizing a variety of tactics in response to the suspect's actions. Further, the time any incident takes will vary based on circumstances and efforts to balance a peaceful resolution. We understand that some in our community may question the duration of this incident or why particular tactics to resolve this situation were implemented. However, this briefing will not discuss specific police tactics, as this would provide information that could be exploited by the criminal element of our society, frustrating future law enforcement operations, thus endangering our personnel. This said, during the negotiations, technological resources, including robots and drones, were utilized in the residence. Throughout the course of the events, some of these resources became disabled, some due to Trevor's actions. Around the 21st hour of the barricade, officers from the Henderson SWAT team entered an unoccupied portion of the residence to recover certain technological resources necessary for our continuing efforts. As officers arrived at the top of the stairs on the second floor, Trevor discharged his firearm from a concealed location. SWAT officer Taylor Young returned fire with his Colt M4 rifle to defend himself and fellow officers as they exited the residence. No officers were injured during this incident. At one point during negotiations, communications was lost with Trevor. Negotiators attempted numerous times to reestablish communication with Trevor. However, communications were never reestablished. At the 37-hour mark of the barricade, with no contact from Trevor for several hours, officers from the LVMPD SWAT team located Trevor, deceased, inside the attic of the residence. If Trevor had survived, he would have been charged with the following: 5 counts, assault with a deadly weapon on a protected person; 1 count, possession of a short-barreled rifle; 1 count of resist with a firearm; multiple counts of discharge a firearm in from an occupied structure; and 6 counts of prohibited person in possession of a firearm. Here is the corresponding relevant radio traffic.
CP. Red. 902, we've got a crash site to push it south. He's gonna come in behind us and work that lock to try to get it out. But I'll let you know we're pushing inside. We're about 2 minutes out from pushing inside.
Copy that. They're still working getting that. And make sure you coordinate with that plan on the 3 side, and you're clear for your plan.
Copy that. RC, just advise if you guys are ready to go with that up.
CNT is still talking to him. He's still inside that room.
RC, let us know when you guys are ready. We're ready to step off here.
Copy. RC set.
That's a good copy. Break, CP. Stand by. We're moving up.
CP copies. Copy.
CP. We can just have, we can just hold the air for us inside. CP. Copy our last.
Copy that.
Negative. Not out. I just need people to hold the air while we're inside.
Copy.
We're making our way in. Inside. Are we comfortable?
Out. Been deployed.
Terrace. Not terrace. Fired, shot fired. Unit does code 4, shot fired from inside.
Negative, changes to the door.
42-1, send 1595.
Go ahead.
Alright, there was a inside from our suspect. Taylor did return fire at this time. We're checking officer right now.
Copy, our officers code 4.
Affirm. Everybody appears code 4 at this time.
Copy. CP. Also be advised, we did return fire. Copy that. Officers return fire. Do we know the status of the suspect? Negative. We did not have a visual on the suspect, just the general direction of where the rounds were coming from. Copy that. So suspect sent rounds towards you, shot at you, and we return fire?
Affirm.
All right, 1401, 1595. Suspect did yell, get out of here, back out, get out of here.
Copy that. Are we thinking he has cameras on us on the interior? How did he know we were inside?
That's unknown, LT. We were trying to step over stuff, so we might have made some noise on the inside. But he may not be hunkered down where we think he's hunkered down. Because if we have eyes on that bathroom door, and they didn't see it move or they didn't see him come out, he's not where we think he is.
Copy that. Any idea where those rounds came from? Could you tell?
1401, 1595. From where Taylor was, it sounds like he's in the near the hallway on the 3 side somewhere. Unknown exactly where he's coming from, but near the hallway is where he's hearing those rounds come from.
Got it.
Body-worn video cameras used by the Henderson Police Department have a 1 minute buffer of video without audio. Upon activation, the camera captures 1 minute of video preceding the activation and begins recording the video with audio. This feature is designed to capture incidents that occur suddenly, where an officer is not able to immediately activate the camera. The cameras are worn at chest level by most officers assigned to field operations, and they capture a general perspective from that angle. Henderson officers are required to wear body-worn cameras during operations. However, available lighting, movement, distance, and other factors can affect clarity and picture quality. The following body-worn video is of relevant footage directly related to the incident I just described.
Hey, hey.
At the conclusion of this incident, detectives recovered 5 rifles, 1 handgun, a gas mask, a tactical belt, and a tactical helmet from the scene. We can confirm Trevor did not suffer any gunshot wounds or apparent trauma. His official cause of death is pending and will be released by the Clark County Coroner's Office.
In the next several months, the Henderson Police Department will continue to investigate and analyze this incident. After the investigation is complete, the findings will be forwarded to the Chief of Police. Thank you for taking the time to view this critical incident community briefing.